Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. NASA and the U.S. Navy were busy recently preparing for tests scheduled off the coast of San Diego, California. Crews will run through the procedures to recover NASA's Orion spacecraft from the ocean following its water landings from deep space missions. Kennedy Space Center, Johnson Space Center, and Lockheed Martin Space Operations are all involved in the recovery effort. During a July 31st briefing at NASA headquarters, agency officials announced that 7 science instruments out of 58 proposed have been selected to be part of the next rover NASA will send to Mars in 2020. The Mars 2020 rover will be a new version of the Curiosity rover currently operating on Mars, with more sophisticated hardware to conduct unprecedented science and exploration technology investigations, including geological assessments, potential habitability of the current environment, and directly searching for signs of past life on the red planet, something no previous Mars mission has done. NASA's Opportunity Mars rover now holds the off-Earth roving distance record after surpassing 25 miles of driving on the red planet since 2004. A 157-foot drive on July 27th put Opportunity's odometer at 25.01 miles. The previous record was held by the Soviet Union's Lunokhod 2 rover on the Moon. Opportunity, Curiosity, and the planned Mars 2020 rover are part of NASA's Mars Exploration Program, which also will prepare for a human mission to Mars in the 2030s. The Intelligent Robotics Group at NASA's Ames Research Center recently conducted the first field test of the newly updated K-REX rover in the basalt hills near California's Central Valley. The testing, funded by NASA's Space Technology, Science, and Human Exploration and Operation Mission Directorates, is designed to prepare for future NASA robotic exploration missions, including improved mobility over difficult terrain and remote control technologies. The European Space Agency launched its 5th and final automated transfer vehicle to the International Space Station from Kourou, French Guiana on July 29th. The ATV-5 cargo spacecraft, named Georges Lemaître after the 20th century Belgian astronomer, is scheduled to complete its 2-week journey to the ISS on August 12th with some 7 tons of food, fuel, and supplies for the Expedition 40 crew on board ISS. The first flight of an ATV was in March 2008. NASA has been out in the community using science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM, to stimulate young minds just in time for back to school. Langley Research Center's recent Technology Day at the Virginia Air and Space Center featured more than 2 dozen exhibits showcasing Langley's technology development in support of NASA's deep space exploration, science, and aeronautics missions. Meanwhile, a similar event hosted by Glenn Research Center at Cleveland's Great Lakes Science Center featured NASA Chief Technologist David Miller, astronaut Doug Wheelock, and Glenn Center Director Jim Free. It included presentations about the important role of Glenn technology in the past success of the Apollo program and how technology will enable NASA to make the next giant leap in spaceflight, sending astronauts to Mars. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.